sorrow.
I get onto Bransome, past North Point Shopping Centre, onto Bransome North, and slow right down as I turn down Saddleworth, which is totally deserted, just a few lights on in the houses dotted here and there. I wind my window down and flash my lamp slowly over the doors. 32, 34, 36, two of them without numbers. Oh, here we go, 44. All the lights are off. I kill the lamp and wind the window back up. Two quick bibs on the horn and number 44 opens. Young lad, probably late 20s. He's got a short sleeve white shirt on and slacks, shoes, best bib and tucker. Looks like he's just got in from going out. Where to, my mate? Ezel Square, he says. Okie doke. I do a three-pointer and spin it back out towards the main road. I can do Ezel from here in about 15 minutes at this time of night, less if I got a pelt on. I turn the radio down a touch, glance in the mirror. The lad's leant back, chewing on his thumbnail, staring out the window. Been round town, mate? I ask him. No answer. Maybe he's a bit mutton. Probably just pissed up. I flick the radio off and put the tape player on. Hank Williams, marvellous. Can't beat a bit of Ham Shank, oh aye.
Everybody's lonesome for somebody.
What? No, oh, he speaks. Have you been round town? Yeah. Bit dead, wasn't it? I was on my way home till I got this job. Mind you, a week before payday, always a bit quiet. Yeah, he goes, but I can tell he's not feeling too sociable. Suits me. I've had people in me fucking tab all night. Not worse than some leery cunt pissed up in the back when you're stone cold sober. We get to the roundabout at the top of Stone Ferry and me laddo in the back leans forward and he says, can you go through town? Eh? I thought you wanted to go to Ezel. Yeah, but just go through town. Be quicker to go straight out and down Clive Sully, I says. I want to go through town, he says. I shrugs. You're the boss, I tell him. This is all I fucking need at this time of night. A tour of all with a fucking mute. What's he want to go round town for? Look at all the pretty lights. Must be looking for someone. Bet it's a bird, bound to be. Probably had some Barney while they've been out and he's fucked off home early in a mood, been sat there working and sent up into a frenzy and now he's looking to drag her back home. Must have a screw loose. I just leave her fucking to it, let her wander round in the freezing cold. And we go over Northbridge and into town. A gang of lads spill out of stackies and start staggering up the road, shoulders hunched against the cold. Look at them silly bastards, I say. Makes you laugh, doesn't it? I mean, they work their balls off all week, lining some other bastards' pockets, then they go out and piss it all up the wall on cards and roulette, pissed out their heads. Wake up next morning, they don't even remember where the money's gone. Barmy, innit? I clock him in the mirror, not even listening. Just staring out the window, chewing on his thumbnail. I hope he's not spitting them fucking nails all over my back seat. I slip down the side of Prospect Centre and hang fire at the junction out onto Ferrin's Way. There's no one about, no cars, fuck all. Seen enough, my mate? I ask him. Ezel? Yeah. Thank Christ for that. I do a left, and then we're out on Clive Sully and heading out west to Ezel. Past St Andrew's Dock, or rather, what used to be St Andrew's Dock. Used to have ships from all over the place in there. Five abreast sometimes. Fucking hamburger bar now. Hamburgers and fucking settees. We belt it past the big lit-up B&Q and take the slip road off past the Sainsbury's and down towards Ezel Square. I turn Hank down. Was it just in the square you wanted, my mate? What? Do you want to be just anywhere here in the square? Whereabouts is the Humber Bridge, he says. You want to go to the bridge? Is it near here? It's up on Boofrey Road, I tell him. Is that far from here? It's a fair walk, I tell him. He straightens up and looks around, bobs down again. Which way is it? I know the fucking score here. Oh, aye. Look, I say to him, I can take you up there if that's where you want to be. I do, he says. I want to be up there. No problem. We drive along in silence through Essel Square. No one about it this time of night, just me, him and Hank. Do you want to go actually over the bridge? I ask him. Silence in the back. I turn the tape down a touch. Hey, son, I say. Do you want to go to the bridge or over it? Just to it, please. Okay, boss, I tell him. And I turn Hank back up and we go up out of Essel and onto Boothry Road. Starts feeling a bit nippy, so I switch the heating on. Full on. It shrieks into the car and within about 2 minutes is roasting. That too warm for you? I ask over my shoulder. It's all right, he says. We get up near the roundabout at the top and the bridge looms into view, red and white lights blinking at the top with a big full moon hung behind it. Stop here, he says. Well, there's a couple of cars at my arse now, headlights in my rear view. Sign at the first exit, toll. Can't stop here, mate, I tell him. If I turn off here, I can't turn around and come back. There's cameras up there. And I don't suppose you want to go to Barton, do you? No, he says. No. I know he fucking doesn't. Sign at the second exit, Humber Bridge car park. Look, I'll drop you off down there, shall I? I says. In the car park? Anywhere around here will do. We roll down into this massive car park ringed off with trees and a small fence. There's a souvenir shop boarded up with a corrugated iron shutter and a small footpath winding up through the trees to the bridge. Two cars parked up at the far side. Apart from that, there's just us. How much do I owe you? He says. I twist round in my seat to face him. Hey, listen to this, I say to him. I had a mate once, you know. He went to Canada, the Niagara Falls. Ever been there? Fucking mad. He says they dress you up in a huge rain mac, you know, like decky learners used to wear at sea. No? Oh, well, you're too young to remember them. Anyway, they stood there in these bright yellow capes and hats on a little ledge with the spray coming at them, pissing wet through there. And there's this bloke there telling them all about how high up it is. A guide, like, you know, saying how much water goes over the edge per second and all that lark. And my mate looks down into the water below, turns round to this guide fella and says to him, do people jump off here often? And the guide says, no, just the once. He just sits there, fucking looking at me, like a gormless cunt.
Now I ain't had a kiss since I fell out of my crib. It looks to me like I've been cheated out of my rib. Everybody's lonesome for somebody else. Nobody lonesome for me.